Hello everyone, Thranxes here, and welcome back to Conan Exiles episode 20, where we have made a little bit of progress since we've been reset back to stone tools, but more importantly, we made a revelation. We had a revelation. Instead of focusing on a building and all of that, while we have these stone tools and our resource gathering is low, we're just going to build a lot of our crafting stations outside. This area here is fairly secure. There's not any enemies. And if we have to build fences or walls kind of at the edges of these areas, that's an easy enough thing to accomplish. There's no need I should have to spend all this time and energy trying to build another building that's just a square big enough for everything that's going to take hundreds and hundreds of stone, when really we just need 500 stone to start smelting the stuff we need for the blacksmith's bench. We will have to make a tannery. Actually, I just realized we'll have to make a tannery, but that's not... Okay, 200 more stone. That's still not going to be a problem. It's not going to be that bad. We're going to be able to start melting iron here really fast, and I think that's the most important part. It's getting back to iron. I know I loved having stuff, and I miss it deeply now that it's gone. So let's get back to the Iron Age. This is a great location. Once we have iron tools and a tanning rack up with all the antelopes and iron nodes around and coal nodes, we are going to be decked out with so much iron and leather, we'll be able to use iron tools and weapons exclusively. There will be no reason not to. That's what I want to get to. I'm sure that's what you want to see me get to. That's what we're going to make happen. We're close enough to the water that we can get it whenever we want, but we're not right up on it. We don't really need to be. There's, you know, bad stuff down there. Really, when you think about it, as soon as we found a really great place that had no enemies, it should have been a no-brainer. Like, there's no enemies here. This is a good spot for our base. Look at that. Because the spawns seem to have very specific locations. Not just for resources, but the animals as well. I always tend to see the same animals in the same location. And even after I kill them and then I come back, they're right back in that location. If I know a rhinoceros is in a certain area, he'll still be in that area when I get back. Whoa, that shadow happened fast. Woo! That made me a little nervous. It's just a shadow. The sun is setting. It's quite common. Happens every day. Deep breath, deep breath. I would also like to put some points into our encumbrance eventually, just so we can carry that much more at a time. Alright, let's go ahead and repair this. Let's go make our forge, and we'll get our forge melting iron right away. We'll be like these little NPC camps. We'll have a lot of our stuff outside, and we'll have some buildings, but we'll have most of our stuff outside. Alright, let's do it. Build a furnace. Then the blacksmith's bench. We'll need more iron and brick. We're going to go take the iron pickaxe and hunt down some iron nodes right after we get this thing burning with the stuff we've already stockpiled. That wind, though. We will need a shelter eventually. It's not something we'll just be able to put off indefinitely. Go ahead and cook the rest of that meat. Oh, it tilts. Okay. No, let's build it. Yeah, let's build it over here up against this rock. I like this. It's kind of a neat area for it. Wonderful. Take the iron. And why not? We'll take the bricks as well for now. Take the iron pick. All right, we'll get this thing going with what we have. Just throw everything in there for now. Oh, and we need to put the extra stone in there. Oh, we don't really have that much extra stone. Oh, yeah, we do. Look at that. Enough to keep the furnace busy for a while, to be quite fair. Oh, look at that. It's a beautiful sight. And truth be told, if you think about it, from a somewhat realistic point of view, do you really want a furnace that you're smelting metal in inside of your home? I mean, I know the home is made of stone, but it's got to be uncomfortably hot and dangerous. The first time you pour some molten metal out and you spill it, which with my luck, I would spill some. Then you got all this molten metal all over the floor of your house, you step in it, now you got an iron boot forever that hurts, that you can't walk on. So we're going to have most of our crafting areas outside. Why not? Maybe we'll be able to build little canopies for them, or, I don't know, overhangs to give them shade and moderate degrees of shelter. One of the things that I saw about this game was how incredibly in-depth the construction was. Ooh, NPCs. Nope. No, no, no. Let's get our bearings. We want to go that way. Yes, this way. Was how incredibly in-depth the construction was, back to what I was saying, in that you can build so many things, and you're not just stuck into like a one mold or one size fits all, that you can really get creative with the way you build your structures. And that's what I want to get into. I want to get into the creative aspect of the structures, where, you know, we're living in this desolate desert world, and we want to build things that resemble that, not just square buildings where we slap all of our crafting tables into one building. I mean, you know, I was getting a feel for the game. But it's not the end game. It's not where we want to end up. Ooh, I'm thirsty. And I did not get water. Okay, so we won't spend very long here. No problem. We'll just get a bunch of iron, and then we'll be gone. Or we'll get a bunch of stone from an iron node. That's bizarre. Not sure what that's all about. I know there's sometimes a rhino that comes down in this area, though. And then we've got NPCs over there. Let's stay away from them. In fact, I'm not seeing a lot of the iron nodes that I thought were over in this direction. Let's not lose my bearings. The river is that way, so let's go this way. I know there are iron nodes down by the river. We just have to worry about the occasional crocodile. We also need water, so we're going to the river. What is that? Is that a crocodile? No, that's like a piece of wood, some kind of fallen tree or something. All right, there's the rhinoceros. Let's stay clear of him. Should be iron on the other bank, I could have sworn. Yeah, let's head over there. I know there's some iron over there. Yeah. Right? I swear there was iron everywhere when I first got here. I wonder if my building structures in this area is... No, because there's coal here. No, it can't be that. Let's go ahead and repair this. We need coal to repair that. Alright, well then let's just stick with what we got for now. Take care of these guys so you're not sneaking up on me. Really kind of a joke. For as big as you are. Really kind of a joke. Alright. I know there was iron over here. And now I can't find it. What is happening? Have I lost my mind? I honestly don't know what's going on. There was all kinds of iron here. I mined it up with my stone pick. Does the iron not respawn as fast as everything else? Because I did not realize that was the case. I might have not mined it all up had I known that. Alright, let's get a little bit of coal. We're going to need some coal. Let's go ahead and get some. I know. I'm probably going to regret doing that. Should have saved my pick for purely iron. But we will need coal too. Crocodile's over here, but I'm pretty sure there was iron over here as well. Iron that I know for a fact I did not mine up, because my encumbrance was just about maxed out. Hold on, there's NPCs over here too, though. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this iron over here is really close to the one of the entrances to this NPC area. Isn't it? How close? Not too close. Double iron. Let's do it. Already got 100. That's grand. Let's keep it up. My goal is to get back into the Iron Age, hopefully by the end of this episode. Might be a lofty goal, might not be doable, but we're gonna see. We're gonna give it our best. Oh, iron, here we go. Lots and lots. Double iron. That's right, give me that double iron. Already over 200. So we're not going to have to worry about iron for a while. We'll be able to do other stuff while the iron is melting. Ooh, out of stamina. We're incredibly encumbered. It's crazy how encumbered we are. And we've literally gathered really nothing but iron. Yeah, I think that's it. We'll head back. So we'll head right back, we'll go to our house. How are we at with branches? 80 branches? Oh, we're good with branches. So we're gonna need bark and a tanning station next, or a tannery rather. Let's stay clear of that entrance. No guards, though. That's peculiar. I swear there were iron nodes on this side of the river over here. It's gotta be just a distance thing, but my buildings are all the way over there. And there's coal... No, it can't be distance, because there's coal nodes much closer to my building than those iron nodes were. They must just have not respawned yet. That's okay. I know a lot of places nearby I can get iron. There's iron up there on those cliffs on that high road there. We can always go and do that. Look at that. Look at that. So much iron. So we're going to need more stone. And we're going to need to make a tannery. So we're going to need a lot more stone and some bark. Okay. I'm okay with that. We can use the rest of this pick. Get a little jump start on the stone, and there it goes. Alright, pick is broken. Let's go ahead and stash it in here. Let's see what do we have here. All of this food. My putrid flesh disappeared again. That's so strange. I need to remember to click and drag the putrid flesh out of there next time if I want to hold on to it. We have some bark, but not enough. And we need a significant amount of stone beyond what we have. See, this stone here has already come back. That makes me think maybe iron has a longer respawn, even longer than coal, perhaps. not certain. Be worth a little bit of a, you know, scientific exploration, maybe. Timing it, mining a node that we know is close, and then kind of hacking the clock and seeing how long it takes for the iron to come back. We're going to need a lot of wood and bark, too. Yeah. Okay, so it's going to take us a hot second to get the stone. Not too long. Oh, did I fill up my flask? I did not fill up my flask. Yeah. So that's a thing. That's alright. Once we get situated with iron tools, the gathering of these resources will be so much easier. And we'll get our iron sword, we'll have a full suit of leather armor. That was like quadruple stone. That was insane. It also broke my pick in a matter of a few swings. That was crazy. Look at all this stone! So many nodes! Oh, look at them all. Yes. This is what we need right here. We'll have our stone requirements in no time. No, it's the wood and the bark I'm worried about. There's just not that many trees nearby. But the trees that are nearby are the small ones, which generally tend to give more bark. So there's that as well. Alright, that's 400 stone. Let's head back and stash it, and then we'll work on the wood and the bark. We'll get the tannery up, and we'll get to tanning this hide. I am most likely going to take the arbalest next level. As much as I want to take the concoctions, if we take the arbalest and we can make a crossbow with bolts and we can kill these antelope way more effectively, we'll be able to get a lot of hide, because we're going to need a lot of hide to keep the tannery full of leather. And there's just not as much stuff around here that gives hide. I mean, the crocodiles, they give thick hide. I guess that's better than nothing. I don't know. Go ahead and take my stone. Look at all that beautiful stuff in the queue. Keep that furnace going. Keep it going. Alright, let's make a trip down here and actually remember to fill up our flask with water, actually. Let's do that. Let's make that a thing. You're so asking for it. You wait. Arbalest is coming. You wait. You, on the other hand, you get a lot of experience. You might be worth leveling up. Seems to be able to hit me further away from where I can hit him. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Looks like the rhino is a good bit away. Yeah, not a lot of bark from the big trees. And these are going to be plant fibers, but we need those too. Nope, not with the axe, with the pick. Get some bark. Or get no bark. It's just completely random. How do you like them apples? All these antelope. Wow, if we had enough iron to just make a huge amount of arrows, we could clean this area up. Don't aggro on me. Don't do it. It won't end well for you, and I don't want to waste the time fighting you right now. I'm on a mission. A very important mission. To regain my honor through iron. I think that's what I'll call this episode. Regained honor. That sounds about right. Come on, bark. I need bark. I'm also going to need a lot of twine. Can't afford to pass up these plant fibers. Okay. Well, you're just asking for it, aren't you? Alright. Let's do this. How do you like that? Mm-hmm. Exactly. Oh, look, another ostrich. I want you. That's what I want. Give me your experience. You have so much to give. Can't believe these birds give as much experience as they do. There you go. Alright, we'll continue gathering our bark now. Just keep this area nice and clean. I feel like there should be an easier way to gather bark. But I guess not. Just gotta get lucky. I felt like the iron pickaxe didn't really give me any more bark than the stone pickaxe did either, which was kind of upsetting. Well, we'll just keep culling this area here. I wonder if there was a way to turn branches into bark. That would be really great. See, I feel like this kind of a tree should give me a lot of bark. Oh, it gave me plus three. Oh, so did this one, though. What about this one? Nope, nothing. Alright, let's keep getting plant fibers. We don't really need the plant fibers for anything other than twine at this point. I don't believe. But we are going to need a lot of twine, so let's continue crafting that. 20 sounds about right. Alright, so we got a crocodile, but we have more trees. Oh, I don't have a bow. Alright, let's do this. I know. Okay. Woo! Woo! It's a little hairy fighting those crocodiles with a melee weapon. But we did it. Now let's just be smart and hang back. I don't see a rhinoceros or anything crazy around here. Oh, you know, we are going to need more stone, too. I forgot. We don't have enough stone in the forest for the blacksmith's bench, so we should probably continue gathering stone. So we're also going to need it for... Well, we have all the stone that we're going to need for the tannery stored in the chest, and then we just put everything else in the forge, but it wasn't enough. We're going to need a couple hundred more, I think, or at least 100 more, minimum. Oh, I go back and forth in my head. I want that arbalest. But then at the same time, I want to be able to make potions and whatever in the cauldron as well. I just know there's going to be some sort of healing item I can make. That would be swell. That would be just grand. Yes, I don't know. We got 3 bark off that big tree. Are you double stone? No, you're just one piece of stone. That's fine. That's okay. I won't hold it against you. Don't worry about it. We can still be friends. So the tannery is going to need 50 bark. And then after that, it's going to need more bark to run. It's going to need bark as fuel. Yeah. Should have been gathering bark this whole time. This whole time. Oh, snap. Did you respawn already? Alright, let's get our stamina back. Oh, you got me anyways. I thought I was far enough away. Darn. Alright, okay, that's fine. Let's repair. Let's go ahead and turn this thick hide into real hide. And we'll repair you and repair you. Yeah, I thought about saving the thick hide. I don't know necessarily what I would do with it. I haven't seen a use for it yet, so I'm just going to turn it into regular hide. We need it anyways. For armor and everything else. All right, we can get more. Oh, look at all these. Whoa. How did I not notice that? No, can't gather anything out of there. The river's full of bones. Danger, danger. It is a treacherous area, but I would have expected to see more bones in the area with those spiders. Goodness. Those things were absolutely crazy. They respawned really fast, like within seconds. I was just astounded once I realized that. It made a lot of sense how I died after that. Oh no, oh no, 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 we picked up too much. Let's repair this and that. There we go, 99%. I'll take it. Let's get back to home base. Get ourselves set up. Did we get 50 bark? Oh, we did not. Okay, fine. We're gonna need more than 50 anyways. I know. Alright, let's look at the blacksmith's bench. It needs 50 bricks, and we have 36 in queue with 15 there. So that's enough. So we have enough, so we don't need to put any more stone in there, actually. We can go ahead and keep the stone in here. The coal, on the other hand, I'm going to go ahead and put in there just to keep it burning. Let's go ahead and take the iron out and then put the iron back in. No, let's take the iron. Yeah, there we go. Put the iron after the stone. That's what I want to see. That's what I want to see. Look at you, you brazen son of a gun. Just all up in my camp. All up in my camp. What else? I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the bark for now, I guess. We don't need that many branches on us. We do want some branches on us, though. Let's go ahead with that. 20 twine. Go ahead and stash that. We don't really need the twine on us, per se. Get rid of this meat. Excellent. Okay, let's go get some more bark. I'll head to where the trees are. We'll just head down the river here. Oh, look, the iron's back. Okay. I knew there was iron close to here. It just takes a little bit to respawn. That's fine. There's a lot of iron over the way, too. In fact, there's a lot of iron in this whole area. There's no reason to sweat the one or two nodes next to the house, and they take a little bit to respawn. I'm not worried about that. Did we have enough? We don't really have a lot of stone to repair our stuff. Let's get some more stone. No reason to pass it up. We'll need it. Ooh, yellow lotus blossom. I bet that has something to do with that cauldron that makes potions. Crocodile. Feel a lot better fighting the crocodile if I had a bow and arrow. Let's just stay away for now. I think that's the best bet. We'll stay over here. We'll get the trees that are close to home. That's a safe bet. Get our 50 bark and, well, we'll need a little extra. We'll need more than 50. That way we can start tanning the leather right away. So maybe we'll collect up to 60 or 70. Should be fine. Then we might need to... Well, we might need to go back to the desert where the hyenas and ostriches are and start culling the ostriches like we had originally said to get our levels. Just to clear all out war on them. They give so much experience. And then once we have an arbalest, then we can kind of go up and down this beach just killing antelopes, crocodiles. Then it will kind of be game on at that point. Repairs that stone pick fast. There's that crocodile. We have a lot of plant fibers. I don't know if we're gonna need more twine right away. might just wait and save these plant fibers so that I can make some gruel with these seeds. Because that Wheel of Pain is... it's coming. It's hot on my list. Oh, but the Arbalest. And the Chemistry Station. The Cauldron. Man. Need more levels. That's why we need the Arbalest. I think that's the strongest argument for the Arbalest, is the fact that we need to be able to level up faster. And being able just to poach these antelope at will would make it a lot easier. I mean, a lot easier. They're all over the place. We'd just be able to wreck shop. And I want to wreck shop. I like to wreck shop, so that's very much something I want to do. Let me repair you with this coal. Good. Alright, let's get some more bark. At this point, I believe we have enough wood and bark and everything we need to make the tannery. So I'm just going to try to get a little bit more so we have some fuel for it. Plant fibers, yes. Yes, yes, plant fibers. And once we make the tannery station and we get some hide curing, hopefully make the blacksmith's bench. And that's where we'll wrap it up. That seems like a good spot to me. Just gathering all this bark off of trees. Man, I never thought the bark would be what took me so long. I gathered everything else relatively quick. I might look that up and see if there's a tool or a way to get bark faster. Just getting it onesie-twosie is so painful. Look at all these antelope. This is Antelope City. Antelope City. Yeah, look at them all. Man. Wait a second. These are different. These have curly horns. Right? Are you worth more experience? You! Oh. Well, I'll be coming back this way. We're definitely getting that arbalest. That's a thing. Okay, alright. Let's head back. That is the one thing I knew this area was going to be a little lacking on, was trees. But we'll just use our pick to get bark whenever possible. And we won't really need wood that often, but because it takes so long to get bark, we can just gather as much bark as we're going to need for the tannery, and that should keep us pretty well stocked on wood. I mean, we already have, what, 100 wood just trying to get bark? 100 more? So. Let's go ahead and collect it all. And where's the bark at? Oh, I can't move. Take it all. Okay. Give me the bark. Oh, we had tons of bark. What was I thinking about? I don't even know. All right, the tannery. Oh, we need the twine. Yep. Get the tannery. And then maybe we'll have enough to make the blacksmith's bench already melted. Perhaps. I did prioritize the stone over the iron, but I know the stone takes significantly longer than the iron does. Let's eat some steaks. We're hungry. We've got good leather, though. Or, well, hide. I guess hide armor is not as good as leather armor, but it's still decent armor. We don't have to worry so much about... oh, look at that. We still got stone for other stuff. That's wonderful. And 44 bark for fuel? That's killer. All right. The tannery should go... no, not next to it. That's where the blacksmith's bench is going to go. You could just put it here. We got grass kind of going through it. So that rotates it. I don't really want to do that. We don't have to put this stuff right on top of it, right on top of each other. We can kind of put it here. Yeah, this way there's no grass growing through it. Excellent. bark and hide. Where are you, hide? There you are. You know what? Give me that too. We've got to catch up. Let's go ahead and throw the hide in there and kick it on. There you have it. Go ahead and craft some more here. Tannery is tanning. The forge is melting. We're just about done melting our stone to be able to make the blacksmith's bench. And by then, we should have the leather we need. Did I rotate this forward just a little bit? I did, didn't I? Well. That's, yeah. It is what it is. I know. It is, too. It's slightly rotated forward. Is it? Yeah, no, it is. You can see the stools slightly. Well. It's just, you know, it's easier to work with that way. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Easier to work with. Oh, I forgot to drag the putrid flesh out. Womp, 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 womp. Oh, well. Let's go ahead and stash a stack of plant fibers, actually. Coal can go straight into the forge. Nope. Nope, nope. So it doesn't look like we're going to get the stone melted and the blacksmith bench up by the end of this episode. I do want to go ahead and wrap it up here. This has been Conan Exiles episode 20. What is that? Wait, what? Is that from the forge? What are those shadows? Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. We are in a sandstorm. We need shelter. Oh no. Not good. Not good. Where's the storm? We need to go. We need to stay out of the storm. Oh no. Oh, we're gonna totally get caught up in it. No. No, no, no. Oh, it's coming. This isn't good. This isn't good at all. I can't even see where I am. Let's go over here. Try to get some shelter, maybe. A little bit of shelter. Oh, man. I can't see anything. No, no, no. Get back in the shelter. Okay. Alright, nope, nope, back in the shelter. I'm just gonna huddle up in this little area here in the rock. And wait for it to pass. Oh, I think that's it. It passed. Oh, wow. Woo! Wow. That was intense. Ooh, right when I was trying to do my sign-off. Man. That's how the first one came right at the end. I could see the shadows. I could see the shadows on the ground. It looked like stuff in the air. Yeah. Okay. Well, we didn't really get attacked by anything. We had this shelter kind of in this rock area here. At least if we died, we wouldn't have lost much. Most of our stuff was... Yeah, see those lines? I don't think that's from my forge. Yeah, because they're all the way over there. Most of our stuff is already being smelted. Oh, look, we do have the stuff for a blacksmith bench. Well, then we're going to go ahead and make it before we sign off. Since we got interrupted anyways. Might as well. Wow. Wow, that was something else. It really was. Couldn't see a thing, even with the torch out. It was just... Couldn't see a thing. Wow. Kind of glad we didn't get attacked by anything, though. I don't know if my my morale could have taken getting killed, even though I'm right here next to my respawn area. With my luck, I would have respawned and then immediately been killed again because I was still in the storm. Blacksmith's bench right there. Look at this. Hold on. We've got leather. We've got branches. We've got iron. At least enough for a tool to get more iron, so we're going to do that. And we're going to queue it up, and I'm not even going to let it finish crafting, though. We're going to sign off for real this time. This has been Conan Exiles Episode 20. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had a good time watching. I definitely had a good time playing, as always. Come back next time as we regain our honor with iron tools, and we survived our first sandstorm by hiding up against this cliff like a little baby. But until next time, take care.